physical fatigue of him and some of his teammates. Just wonder you from a leadership perspective, how you've noticed that play out, whatever the case may be, the last couple weeks, whatever it is, and how you've been trying to kind of get through this patch as a team to get to the break.
Just just trying to stay in the moment. I mean, for me, just staying in the moment, keeping my guys motivated, keeping them, you know, upbeat. And you could definitely tell that, you know, some of our guys are just feeling the midst of the long season that we had last year with the bubble, and then coming right back on to the season this year. So a lot of guys are looking forward to the break, so it'll be beneficial to our guys.
I guess for tonight's matchup, but then just in general, how do you feel about with no AD, with no Bart, going small, trying to stay big? How difficult is that within the course of a matchup tonight and tomorrow night as well?
Well, it's no AD, no Mark, and no Kuz. This is three of our top six rotational players, major pieces. So, difficult challenge for us, but, we had some good contributions tonight. I thought, Dez gave us some great minutes. I thought, Taylen gave us some good minutes, and also D. Jones gave us some good minutes too in the little amount of minutes that he played. So, we just try to pick up for guys when guys are out.
Okay, David Menard, please.
Well, Rod, two quick ones for you. The first on the game, when Booker was ejected, do you feel like that had any effect on you guys as a group, either way, or the rest of the game?
No.
Okay, and secondly, you were wearing some bright green FAMU sneakers. Any story behind that?
Well, first of all, Nike is always, been a great supporter of FAMU, and obviously, my ties with Nike, and obviously, my ties with wanting to support, the HBCUs and FAMU being one of them. That's a great institution, and I was happy I was able to, rock those tonight, and hopefully something, in the near future can come about it. So, it's a great school, like I said, a great institution, and I was happy to be able to, showcase those kicks for the night, and, continue my support, for, these black colleges.
LeBron, going back to Dave's first question, what was your perspective on Booker's ejection, and did you see that as a justified ejection? And then, as a competitor, how do you feel when you see another All-Star leave a game like this?
I don't know. I mean, I was focused on the game, to be honest. I don't know what was said, out on the floor. So, you always want to compete against the best, and, you don't ever want to see someone get ejected, but I have no idea what was said on the floor, so I don't know.
Okay, Calgary, please.
Hey, LeBron. You guys have been talking about preparing for this kind of moment, these kind of hits to your depth, and obviously you never know what's going to happen this season, but is it just different going through it when you hear about Mark out in the afternoon, Kuz out on the sport tip-off, you just feel like it's just hard to even tackle until you're experiencing it?
But yeah, even though we, we've been, prepared all season, knowing the COVID rules and COVID and things of that nature, that you could be hit with some spontaneous, guys being out, very rapidly and things of that nature. But it's always tough, especially we played so well the last two games. We're getting back into a rhythm, and then we find out today, two of our big guns are out. So, it's definitely deflating, especially when you were playing poorly, and then you get a good rhythm, and then you hit with that. So, it definitely hurts our ball club.
Okay, Dan
White,
please.
Hey, LeBron, two real quick ones. At the end of the game, I think it was Abdul Nader kind of stole the ball when you were trying to dribble out the clock. I'm just curious your reaction to that. And then sort of secondly, when you have a player who enters the protocol, potentially positive for a positive test, I guess, are there anxious moments that kind of surround that, knowing when you see what happens in, Toronto, what was happening in Washington, and with some other teams, stuff like that?
Listen, you played a game to the end of the end of the clock, play it to the zeros. So that's my answer to the first one. To the second one, No, I mean, you listen, we have our COVID rules and we have our COVID restrictions and guidelines, things of that nature. So just to try to abide by them, try to stay healthy, try to stay safe, and take care of what you can, you know, you can take care of, and what you can't control, you don't.